actualization. This is the third and final phase of a transformational journey. Actualization involves the realization of a vision in actual working practice. This requires the creation of ways and means to deliver upon an image of the future. The primary task in the actualization phase is to formulate and implement an organizational strategy such that its mission and vision can be realized in the spirit of stewardship or trusteeship. This endeavor often involves the reinvention of the business model as well as the cultural pillars of the organization. Thus, the three elements of actualization are stewardship, strategy, and reinvention. The saga and the story of the Aravind Eye Care system and its founder, Padma Shri Dr. Govindappa Venkataswamy, perfectly illustrates the process of actualizing an articulated vision. Dr. V, as he is fondly known, retired as the head of ophthalmology from the Madurai Medical College in 1973 and formed a vision of eliminating needless blindness in India. In order to be able to do this, Dr. V established an 11-bed eye clinic known as Aravind by pooling life savings from his own career as well as of those members of his extended family whom he had recruited to join in this mission. The team established three elements of the organization's strategy at the very outset. First, we shall not turn away any patient, irrespective of the person's economic capacity. Second, we shall never compromise upon quality. And third, we must remain financially self-reliant so as to never compromise upon our freedom. Thus, Dr. V never raised any external funds or donations when he started the Aravind Eye Care system. Marketing was directed exclusively at people who did not have the capacity to pay. 60% of the services were to be offered for free. All the same, world-class quality was to be offered and maintained at all times. An organization founded on this seemingly absurd framework is paradoxically the largest provider of eye care in the world today. So how was this accomplished? There were five foundational factors that were woven together into a dance of synergistic performance that led to the actualization of Dr. V's vision. The first was his focus on cataract treatment. Even though cataract caused 2/3 of the blindness in India, there were still other factors such as lifestyle, customs, and culture that were causes of blindness. But Dr. V focused on cataract. Second, Aravind had a hybrid business model of free patients as well as fee-paying patients. Even though fee-paying patients were initially the source of funds for the institution to perform its charitable work, it later developed that they were also an excellent source of market feedback that nudged Aravind to always maintain a high level of quality, and that effect rubbed off on the free patients too. The third was high operational efficiency. Dr. V realized that cataract surgery and all its ancillary activities were amenable to standardization. In essence, Dr. V successfully adapted the McDonald's model of standardization to as complex a field as eye care. There was a strong element of reinvention here. Fourth, spirit of service. An as expansive a vision as the ability to gift eyesight to needy people was the human engine that egged on the 4,000 strong group of people that run Aravind. And finally, vertical integration. The two most important elements of successful cataract surgery are the intraocular lenses and the ophthalmic assistants who assist the doctors in carrying out the surgery. Aravind developed Aurolab, its own facility for manufacturing these lenses, and every year it takes a batch of about 100 girls recruited from the local villages and trains them for 2 years and thus turns them into very highly trained ophthalmic nurses. So these five elements came together to help actualize Dr. Govindappa Venkataswamy's vision. As they say, an institution of the people, by the people, and for the people shall never perish from this earth. Likewise, Aravind seems destined to serve humanity for all times to come. Thank you.